Welcome to the first supermarket in the world that gives you money, $5,000. And we give it away time and time again. Since $5,000 is serious money, you have to do some serious shopping to earn that $5,000. The whole idea is to shop faster and smarter than the next person. Go ahead, grab everything you can get your hands on. Then fill up your cart as high as you can. Sure, it may look like hard work, but you know what? It's a lot of fun, too. When you win the $5,000, sometimes you get carried away, and sometimes you'll even be moved to tears. So get ready, because you never know what's going to happen on Supermarket Sweep. Are you ready to go shopping? Who's got the Otter Pops? Okay, you're on. Who's got the Swanson Fried Chicken? Okay, you're on. Who's got the Spick and Span? Okay, and you're on. We're ready to play Supermarket Sweep. And here is our host, David Ruprecht.
Oh, thank you. Hi there. Thank you. Hello there, and welcome to Supermarket Sweep. As you know, one of these teams could be going home with $5,000. And to help them do that, we're going to give each team a free 1 minute and 30 seconds to use in the big sweep. But right now, I'm going to give someone a quick chance to pick up 10 seconds and a cash bonus. So whoever wants to play first, step on forward and buzz in just as soon as you think you know what I'm talking about. An honest president was born in one of these. Greg.
Log cabin.
That's it. Good for you. Abe Lincoln was born in a log cabin, so that's 10 seconds for Greg. Now, Jim, since Greg got that right, we're going to give you a chance to pick up a quick $50 if you can find some log cabin syrup in a specially marked box and bring it back to me in 30 seconds. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, go. Good luck. Go, go.
Go, Jim.
25 seconds. 20 seconds. Come on. Come on, Jim. Come on, Jim. Uh-oh. 10 seconds. Got it. 5 seconds. Oh, that's okay. Come on, Jim. Sorry. At least you got your exercise today, right? Okay, that's all right. You didn't. You get the 50 bucks, but you do have that extra 10 seconds right. That's going to help you out when you go out in the sweep. Right. Thanks a lot. Okay. All right, let's see. While Jim is catching his breath, let's see who else we have playing. Tammy, how do you know Jamie?
She's my best friend.
For how long, Jamie?
About a year and a half.
Really? Where did you guys meet?
At Edwards Air Force Base.
So, are you in the service?
No, our husbands.
Your husbands are?
Mm-hmm.
Great. They didn't go over?
No.
No. Okay, good. Well, it's good to have you here. Andrea, how do you know Tanya?
Tanya's my sister.
Ah, so I won't ask you how you guys met, because we know. Tanya, what do you do?
I'm a hairdresser, and I work at home, at the house.
And Andrea?
I'm a secretary for a collection department.
Great. Now, Jim, how do you know Greg?
We're roommates at UCLA.
Studying what, Greg?
I'm studying economics.
With an eye at?
I'm not sure yet, but I'm sure I'll find something.
You don't have to worry about it yet, do you? Okay.
No,
how about you, Jim?
Political science.
Oh, you're going to be president?
Maybe, I don't know.
Well, it's great to have you all here. It's going to give our first players a chance to earn some extra seconds right now, so that means that Andrea, Jim, and Tammy, we'll see you all later. All right, now, for you three, as you know, a proverb is sort of a popular expression. Just fill in these blanks with the food that completes these old proverbs. You ready? Here's the first one. One bad blank can spoil... Jamie.
Apple.
That's it. Good for you. There's 10 seconds for Jamie. Moving you up into a tie for the lead with Greg. Here's the next one. You can catch more flies using honey. Greg.
And...
You can catch more flies using honey than you can... Jamie.
Vinegar.
That's it. Then you can use some vinegar. Yay. Moving Jamie into the lead with a minute and 50 seconds. Here's the next one. That's the way the blank... Greg.
Ball?
No. Tanya.
That's the way the ball bounces?
No. That's the way the blank crumbles. Jamie.
Cookie.
There you go. Good, Jamie, you waited for the whole clue. It could have been the ball bounces, but we were working with crumbles here, and that was cookies, and that moves Jamie even further into the lead with 2 minutes. Here's the last one in our proverb game. Too many cooks spoil the... Jamie.
Soup?
No. Too many cooks spoil the... You know what it is now, Jamie?
I think I do.
What do you think it is?
I can't remember.
Broth.
Oh.
Almost a soup, but not quite. The actual proverb is too many cooks spoil the broth. So let's see. Jamie's in the lead with 2 minutes. Greg has 1:40. Tanya, you got 1:30. Well, why don't we bring your partners up right after this? Now, for those of you at home, history notes that early in the 1870s, a Philadelphia pharmacist spent his honeymoon on a New Jersey farm. It was there that he discovered an exciting new drink made of 16 different ingredients. If you have any idea what drink, I'll give you a hint. It's a type of beer. We'll tell you when we come back.